is not just about your attitude, because your attitude will also create the attitude of those people who work for you. You know, I always used to say that, you know, if we've decided to do something and if the results are different from what we've done, we have to be able to very candidly say, what is it that we could have done to change the outcome? So the focus is not on your effort. The focus is not on how hard you've worked. The focus really is, are you working hard on the right things? Are you spending your time on those things that will make the big difference? So hard work is important, but hard work which is directed and focused in the right direction is what will produce results. So there are a lot of people, you know, you meet who say that I worked really hard and nothing happened. Sometimes that's also true. Sometimes you might have an idea that is ahead of its time. Sometimes you might have an idea, but someone else comes up with the same idea and is able to execute it better than you can execute it. So in business, one of the other things that I've learned is that it is good to have clarity, it is good to have a goal, it is good to have a strategy, but all of that without having a really good ability to execute. And by execute, I mean who is going to do what? What is the process we are going to follow? How do we go from where we are to where we want to be? Those are the matters of execution. So you can have a great plan, great thoughts, wonderful passion, all of those things. But if in execution, you're not paying enough attention to detail, things can go terribly, terribly wrong. And at the end of the day, it's not about what you say, but about the results that you produce that matters. So execution, therefore, you need to really surround yourself with people who are not similar to you. That's another thing. You know, sometimes we say we like to feel comfortable with people. But if you surround yourself with people who are similar to you, you're not getting the diversity that you need, that every business needs to flourish. And in the absence of that diversity, you are not going to be able to realize the full potential of what you want to do. So surrounding yourself with smarter people, surrounding yourself with people who have the right skills, and more importantly, surrounding yourself with people who have the right attitude. People have to buy into your vision. You know, and every company has its own vision and way of operating. The way Fab India works is very different from the way Good Earth works, from the way Biba works, but they're all successful. So you have to determine what is your DNA that you want in your business. What is going to be that special uniqueness that you bring to what you do that is going to differentiate you from everybody else? Because there'll be many people who come and compete in the same space. And you know, right now we can see what is happening in the e-commerce world. Everybody wants to launch a portal, everybody wants to do everything, and then the only thing you can do is to offer big discounts. You will have a lot of customers and very big discounts, but where is the money? So the last thing I want to say to all of you is that at the end of the day, business is about the ability to make money. Yes, you have to invest. Yes, there will be a gestation period. Yes, there will be times when initially you will not make money. That is why it is called an investment phase. But intrinsically, very quickly, you have to come to a business model where you have defined quite clearly and specifically how the activities are going to be performed, what is going to be the cost of each of those activities, what is the revenue that you're going to generate, and at the end, if you're not generating more revenue than the costs that you have, you're not going to have an enduring business. You may get investors initially who believe in you, who say that you're really competent and I'm going to put my money behind your venture. But at the end of the day, the purpose of business, the purpose of any commercial venture is to create a surplus. Because if you're not creating a surplus, you're not going to be able to pay your employees, pay your shareholders, pay yourself, and make the business sustainable. And you know, it goes from the sublime to the ridiculous. Large businesses have folded up. We all know of an airline called Kingfisher who got into so much of debt. It was a great brand. It was a great experience for customers. But if you are not able to find a way to make money at the end of the day, that business is not going to be sustaining or enduring. And therefore, it is always a good idea, initially, to be very careful with, you know, the costs that you're incurring, how you're approaching the business that you are doing, which become very, very critical. So I would say that in summary, you know, at least what I've always done, every time a new opportunity has come my way, I say I ask myself three questions. And if the answer to all three questions is yes, I go ahead and do it. So the first question is, am I going to learn anything? You know, in doing this new thing. The second is, am I going to be able to contribute to what I'm doing? Of course, in my case, I'm a professional. I've not been an entrepreneur, as I said. So, you know, my decisions always were, am I going to be able to learn anything out of this new opportunity? Am I going to be able to contribute anything to the business? And third and most important is, am I going to have fun doing it? Because frankly, when you are having fun doing something that you do, it doesn't matter how long you work. If you're not having fun doing what you're doing, even an hour can be very, very tedious. So the important thing is you've got to create around you an environment and an atmosphere which brings out the best, not just in yourself, but also brings out the best in other people that you're going to be working with. Because only then can you have fun, and only then can you, you know, really work hard, but also have a good time and feel quite successful at the end of it all. Because, you know, what gives all of us great pleasure and joy and excitement is to say that I made this happen. Now, whether this is a school that you might want to start, whether this is an NGO that you want to start, whether this is, you know, a new business that you want to start, a new manufacturing unit that you're going to start. What matters in the end is what have you managed to create, not just for yourself, but for the society, for the community around you, and for the people around you. I will leave it to questions. I'm sure there'll be lots of questions which are about, you know, women have to juggle so many different responsibilities, manage the home, manage this, manage that. But you know what? Juggling multiple stakeholders is something that we simply have to accept. Because what choice do you have? And when you don't have a choice and you accept it and you say, I'm going to be smart about the way I'm going to juggle my responsibility and manage the various edge to change. So change management, whether it is a family business or a professional business, is a long-term path. It's not going to happen because you're the youngest and you've got an MBA and you'll come and tell your uncles or great uncles or great aunts what we've been doing is wrong. This is the way to do it. Nobody's going to listen to you. You have to be sensitive. You have to show them another way of doing things. You have to do it with sensitivity. You have to do it sensibly. You have to make yourself credible before somebody starts listening to you. Because, you know, none of us have the divine right to be listened to. People must feel that, yes, you bring an added dimension. People must feel that, yes, you bring a new perspective. People must feel that with your perspective, they can get further than they've been getting with their own perspective.